This video is on how to release energy from past relationships. And this could be a romantic relationship or one that wasn't romantic. Because when we're in a relationship, we actually have ties to the other person. And maybe the relationship ended not so good, and you may feel some resentment, some anger, some fear. So you're still connected. And in order to completely move on and take your power back, you need to cut that cord. You need to cut that energetic cord between the two of you. And when you do, that's when you're allowing new things to come into your life from the universe. It's kind of like you have unfinished business. Now, if this was a romantic and an intimate relationship, it even gets a little more complicated because there were hormones that were exchanged and that are kind of in your body and the other person's body. So that way, when you break up with an intimate relationship, it's even more important to do this kind of step. So I'm going to walk you through what to do. It's a very relaxing, simple, and extremely effective technique. I've used it with a lot of my clients. And you just have to listen, and then I'll give you some suggestions at the end on how you could move on even more. But before we start it, I want to do something that's with energy medicine, and it's called the Zip Up. And what the Zip Up does, it traces your central meridian. So if you're taking on the energy of others by doing this, you're kind of releasing it, coming back into your own power. And when I took a workshop on it, it was like amazing, the results. And so to do this, very simply, you just take one hand, go from your pubic bone up to your lower lip. Just boom, like that. And what you are, you're zipping up your energy in your central meridian. So do that before we get started here. Okay, now I want you to just close your eyes and relax. Take a few deep breaths. Kind of get comfortable wherever you are. Kind of try to release any tension. And I want you to visualize that you are on a beach. It's a beautiful day. There's a slight breeze. The sun feels great, not too warm, not too cold. And you're looking out at this vast ocean. And in front of you, there's a dock. And there's a boat tied to the dock. And in this boat is the person from your past that you want to release today. So I want you to get up from your chair and walk over to the boat and talk to this person. Tell them anything that you have left unsaid, how they made you feel, how they hurt you, how you're feeling now. Everything you want to say, go ahead and say it to them. You're safe. It's okay. Let your feelings out. Now I want you to thank them. Thank them, is it for the lessons, for the good times? Thank them. Wish them well and say goodbye. Now the boat is tied to a dock. I want you to actually untie that. Undo the tie, hand them the rope, and watch the boat go towards the horizon. You're just standing there watching and taking some deep breaths. And the boat is getting smaller and smaller and smaller until it goes over the horizon and you can't see it anymore. But on the horizon, you see a speck coming. And it's another boat. And as it gets closer, what does this boat look like? Who is on the boat? Now this boat is bringing you all your dreams and wishes. Are you on the boat? Is there a spiritual advisor or guide on the boat? Is there somebody on the boat with you? I want you to feel your dreams being delivered to you. How does that make you feel? This is the boat of dreams and possibilities. And it's coming closer and closer and closer. Imagine your dreams. What do you see? How do you feel? And I want you to put your hands over your heart and say, I love you. And I am ready to move on. Now, when you're ready, slowly open your eyes and come back into the room. So, how do you feel? Now, sometimes you may have to do this more than once, but it's really effective to do two other things. First, journal. The top of the page, after this, I felt. And write without judgment. After this, I felt. How did you feel? Relieved? Maybe still there's a tie? Then do it again, maybe tomorrow. But journal your feelings down. Get them out. Don't hold them in. Get those feelings out. And then the second thing I want you to do for the next week, whenever you think of this person, this will take time where you don't think of them, I want you to wish them well. What that is, instead of resentment, hurt, betrayal, you're putting like a mirror in front of you. So whatever feelings they have, they're going to bounce right off because your mirror is positive. Wish them well. When you think of them, all I have to do is, I wish them well. I wish them well. I wish them well. You repeat this, you wish them well, and you will feel in more power. You'll have more energy, and you'll be ready for what you want to come into your life. If you enjoy this video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel. Sending you lots of love and light. Until next time.